Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to Muhammad Sheikh's channel. Please click the bell icon so that you may receive timely notifications of our upcoming videos.
Now this word is very important for our lecture, and that is Al-Ghanim. The word Ghanim is translated by the few people in the English translation as booty or loot. In Arabic language, Ghanim means the prophet. The prophet. In Urdu, it will be Munafa. In English, the word is Ghanim. The translation for that is the prophet. And in Urdu would be Munafa. But the Arabic language is such, there are certain words of Arabic language which is also are used in the similar fashion. The name is the same and in the meaning is different. In Arabic language there is a word nafa. In Arabic language there is a word nafa'a, which is translated in English as advantage. Advantage. And in Urdu language will be faida. But in Arabic when it is nafa, in English is advantage or faida. And when it is ghanim, the English language says, translate is profit, and Urdu is nafa. And the word ar-riba, the topic ar-riba means the increase. The increase, where normally people have translated as usury for riba. If you see Surah Al-Anfal 8 and Ayah 41, where we will see how and what Allah describes about interest or increase, the riba, the increase. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ وَلِلرَّسُولِ وَلِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ. Know that surely whatever ghanim profit you get from anything, if you believe in Allah, then surely one-fifth of it, sadaqa, charity is for Allah, that is God, and Rasul, that is the messenger, and for the qurba, the relatives, and for yatama, the orphans, and for the masakin, the needy, who are reduced to poverty, and for Ibn Sabil, the sons of the way. This verse, I will discuss this verse in portions. First of all, one sentence, the first phrase, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, and know that surely whatever ghanim profit you get from anything, it simply means this. Now, the people have translated this word ghanim as loot and booty in other people's translation. Here, if you note, wa'alamu, I'll first explain what has been already written, and then we'll have a comparative view what I'm translated as ghanim, as prophet. Wa'alamu annama ghanimtum min shayin, and know that surely whatever ghanim profit, instead of I write profit, I write booty, as what people have written. Booty means loot. You get from anything. What it is, in other words, Allah is ordering the believers that whatever, know that whatever loot or booty you get from anything, you get from anything. And then the categories are defined, that is for Allah, that loot is for Allah and the messenger, and then that is for the, they are the categories. Before going to the categories, I'm just trying to put it in your mind that is God justified to loot the people's money and then give it to God? Does it make sense? No. And then if it is, they say it was between the wars, when the wars took place, and when we, as I explained in the Bible, when you take up the country, you loot the people's money. Is it justified? That is not, that's in the Bible, not in the Quran, that you loot and give it to the people. That is for God. So the translation I'm telling you in dictionaries, there is a translation for the word ghanim as profit. At the same time, there is a word loot also and booty also. So you have to use your mind and think, would Allah ask the believers that they should fight first, and once they conquer the lands, and then they loot, as mentioned in the Bible. Not so. So now if I translate this meaning here as prophet, whatever, know that surely whatever profit you get from anything, then surely these are the categories. Then again you think that now we have to be, this 20% in one-fifth is 100, out of 100 is 20. Out of 100 units, 20 is the one-fifth. Now if you note that in the world, no one is giving 20%. Because you are expecting a war should take place among the believers against the non-believers, and you should win the war. And after winning the war, you loot the people of the poor people, and then you give it to God Almighty and this and that, Mal Ghanimat. That still we are waiting for thousands of years to do so. We are always losing the wars against the non-Muslims. So they are loot. They are doing the same. They are looting you, and they are taking the booty and becoming the powerful, taking the oil wealth. Why are you getting angry? If you are supposed to do the same thing, if the non-Muslims and the Christians are doing the same to you, which you think God has ordered you to do it. For they can produce the evidence, this is the Bible. In the Bible it is written like that, you attack the city. If they don't surrender, attack the city. And then take the loot, capture the, kill the men, keep the women alive, and the livestock and all the belongings, you take it. But if you say that it is our also the same law, the Quran doesn't say that. So there is no war here, there is no nothing. So whatever business you are doing, or you are doing a job, or anything, from anything you get profit, these are the shares. So this is the first explanation of the part. Now I have to explain to you, these categories here Quran says are six. وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّمَا غَنِمْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَأَنَّ لِلَّهِ خُمُسَهُ وَلِلرَّسُولِ وَلِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ. And know what surely, whatever ghanim profit you get from anything, if you believe in Allah, then surely one-fifth of the sadqa charity is for Allah and the Rasul, the Messenger, and the for qurba, the relatives, for yatama, the orphans, and for the masakin, the needy, who are reduced to poverty, and for the sons of the way. These six categories and two further categories, people have to give. Now the question is, if people do not give this 20% out of 120, what word, one word you will give for those who are not giving in 100 unit, 20 you have to give. The remaining is at 80 is yours. And if you do not give 20, then what that 20 will be in the 100? What English word you will give? In 100, you have to give 20. And if you do not give 20, then what would be the word, one word, 20 would be what? Increase. Because that is not yours. It is like you go to the shop, you buy something, and you give some money to him, and you take something, and then you expect the change, you take the change. But he gives the same amount back to you. So you say, you're giving me excess money, that's not mine. That excess is increase. So in 120 is you have to spend in the way of Allah. And if you do not spend, that 20 is an increase in your wealth. And that increase word in Arabic is riba. Yes, please.
841, there is Surah Anfal.
Yes.
Almost all the translators have said Ghanim as booty.
Booty.
But you have jumped up to another word.
Prophet.
That is prophet. I would like to learn the name of the dictionary from where you come.
You see, you can find, I will give you, there are many dictionaries, but one of the dictionaries I can say, you can write down the name, Arabic English dictionary by Hansberg. An amazing part, this Arabic English dictionary by Hansberg, edited by J.M. Cowan, on page number 803, you can find this. You can write down the dictionary where you can find the translation of Ghanim as prophet. Another Arabic English dictionary is by Steingass, page number 765. There are two different dictionaries in the world, and you can find that. they have translated as ghanim as profit. And an amazing part is that if you inform this dictionaries to these label Muslims, they said they are Jews. They are Christians. Any dictionary of the world has nothing to do with religion. They will just say what this word means in the world. So they have also put booty in the dictionaries. They have also put loot in the dictionaries, because the Jews and the Christians, Arabs, are looting the, because the Bible says that you loot and booty after the war, you capture. So they, in the Bible, they have written down for loot. For them also in Arabic, they have used the word loot and booty also in Arabic dictionary. But in Arabic language, they will write down booty, loot, and profit. Now you have to use your mind. Would Allah will ask us to loot the people, or Allah is asking to give from the 20 or whatever the amount has come to? You have to use your intelligence.
Part B of my question. The meaning of riba, you have said increase. How you got that?
Again in the dishes I will refer to, okay, the same Arabic English dictionary for Hansberg, edited by J.M. M. Cowan, page number 374, Arabic English dictionary by Steingass, page number 400. Another thing is, the word increase is translated almost everybody in the ayah or room 3039 and Surah Al-Baqarah 2276. Everyone has translated at the riba. When I was giving my talk, he said, you circle this word, it's the riba. And if you look at the translation of every scholar, it will say increase. I am translating the word, the riba is increase, of course. But at the same time, other people is also translating. In Surah Rum 30, ayah 39 verse, and Surah Al-Baqarah 2276 verse, where Allah says, I will read those ayahs if you want, that it says, Surah Rum 30, it says, وَمَا عَتَيْتُم مِن رِبَى لِيَرْبُوا فِي أَمْوَالِ النَّاسِ فَلَا يَرْبُوا إِنْدَ اللَّهِ. It says in Arabic, وَمَا عَتَيْتُم مِن رِبَى, and whatever you give from the riba, means the increase, liyarbu, so that you increase, fi amwalin nas, in the wealth of mankind, fala yarbu, it does not increase in the nearness of Allah. The word, root letter, Arabic word, riban, liyarbu, la, fala yarbu, is the same root letters all the time. And all these three words, the meaning is increase, increase, increase. And all the translations of the world have translated here as increase. And one of the ayah also I said in Surah Al-Baqarah 2276, Yamhaqullahu riba, Allah cancels the riba, wa yurbis sadaqat, and again sadaqat, he increase. Again the word yurbi is used from the same root letters riba. Again the word here is increase the sadaqat, the charity. So there are, even here also the people have to translate the word for riba, yurbi, is increase. In the dictionaries also mentioned, and as well as the Quranic ayat translations, people have translated the word as increase in one or two, these two ayats as well.